Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to go over five tools that I use every day in Photoshop. And actually, some of them aren't necessarily tools, but they are just parts of Photoshop that I find very useful. All right, let's get started. The first thing I use all the time is Select Subject. So I've got an image that I downloaded from pexels.com. I'm going to bring that in Photoshop, and then I just hit W. W brings you to your magic wand tool, and then you get this at the top. And from here, I can just hit select subject, and it takes a second. And then depending on how much contrast there is between your subject and the background, it usually does a really nice job of selecting the subject. So at this point, I can hit Command J or Control J, and then hide my background, and you can see what we've got here. Now, it didn't do a perfect job, so if you see parts of it like this, you can come back into your background. I'm gonna hide the layer I just made, and then I'm gonna hit Q on my keyboard. Q is my quick mask, it's right down here. With this, you can kind of paint your selection. So I'm gonna hit B on my keyboard. I'll make sure that black is in front. If you don't have black and white here, you can just hit D on your keyboard. I'm going to kind of paint these on the parts that are missing, and then I'll get white in front to delete parts that I don't want. So obviously it's not perfect, but it does a really nice job a lot of the time. Usually I don't even have to do cleanup like this at all. Now I'll hit Q again to get back to my selection. I'm just going to take a look at the rest of this. I'll hit Q to paint this part on. And Q again to get back to the selection. Then I'll hit Command J or Control J, and it's done a pretty nice job. So now I could put him onto a new background if I wanted to, or just go ahead and make changes. So Select Subject is something that saves me a ton of time. Especially if you have a subject on just a white background, it does a really great job in that instance. The next tool that I use all the time is Straighten. As you can see in this photo, I did not do a very good job of keeping my horizon line straight. So to fix this, I'm going to hit C on my keyboard. That'll get me to the Crop tool, which is right up here. And then I'll choose Straighten right up here at the top. Now, once I've chosen this, I'll need to click on one part of the horizon and drag all the way over here, and then it automatically rotates and crops it where it needs to go. So I'm going to hit Enter or Return to commit the changes, and now it's completely fixed. The third tool I really like is Rotate Canvas. So all this one does is rotate the canvas so that it's easier to paint, to brush, to erase something. So I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to hit B on my keyboard, and let's just say I want to draw along this edge of the flower. Well, that's okay. Until I get down here, I just don't do well with drawing downwards. So I'm going to undo. Instead of doing it that way, I'm going to hit R on my keyboard, and that'll get me to this Rotate Canvas tool right down here. I'm just going to rotate this around, and then I can go ahead and draw at an angle that's easier for me. So for me, it's easier to go left to right instead of up and down. So I'm just hitting R and B to get back and forth between those two. And then I'll hit Escape to get it back to 100%. Now, I just drew this with a mouse, so it doesn't look very good, but I usually use this with my drawing tablet. You can also use it for erasing parts of your image, or use it with a clone stamp. It's really, really handy. The next tool that I really love is the Content Aware Fill tool. So that's right up here under Edit, and then Content Aware Fill. You have to have something selected though. So I've got this image of a waterfall, and let's say I wanna just get rid of this building and this building. So I'm gonna hit L on my keyboard to get to my lasso tool, and I'm just going to loosely draw around those things. And then I'll hold Shift to get this one over here. Okay, so both are selected, and I'm gonna zoom out a little bit just so you can see them a little better. And I'll come up here to Edit, Content Aware Fill. And here's the result. It's completely removed those, and it's really pretty hard to tell where they were. You can kind of see the shadow right here, so you know, we could fix that later. But what Photoshop does is it takes everything in this green area and tries to fill in this area with the surrounding foliage or pixels or whatever's there. And it can kind of tell that the white of the waterfall is not what we're wanting, so that part's not green. If you don't like something over here that it's pulling from, you can just delete that part. Like, I don't want any waterfall at all, so I'll delete that. I don't want that little dark area or this right here. So you can see it change over here. Actually, I don't like that as much, so I'll put that back. And then we'll say okay. And now those two buildings are just completely gone. So content-aware fill is something I use all the time. It's so handy. And then the fifth tool I've actually already mentioned, and that is the Quick Mask tool. And it's really helpful to add to selections or modify selections. So on this one, I'm going to select the subject. I'll hit W and then choose Select Subject. And then I'll hit Q to get to my Quick Mask tool. And I'm going to zoom in. And now we can really see what the select subject has selected. I'll hit B to get on my brush tool. Now this is a mode, so anything you brush is going to affect what areas are selected, if that makes sense. If we have black in front, it will add to the selection. If we have white in front, it will delete from the selection. So I want white in front right now. And I'm just going to remove this part that it didn't quite get right. And then I'll hit X to bring the black in front to draw on the part that it missed. Right here, it's having trouble telling the difference between the color of his jacket and the grass, because they are very similar right there. So this looks pretty good. I'll hit Q to get back to my selection, and then Command J or Control J to duplicate him onto a new layer. So Quick Mask is also one of my favorites in Photoshop. All right, I hope you found this video useful. If you have a part of Photoshop that you're using all the time, please leave that in the comment section below. And I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you.